Hey folks, I'm Adam from World's Greatest, and today we're going to be checking out one of the greatest abandoned structures of all times. We're going to talk about the Pontiac Silverdome. We're going to cover why it's called the Silverdome, considering it's white, how you could have bought it for a little over $500,000, and give you a history, including its demolition, and tell you what sits there today. And before we continue, just a special thanks to our sponsors, Thinergy. I use it, and if you're looking to lose weight and have a little more energy in your day, check out Thinergy. There's a link below. So go ahead, sit back, kick back, enjoy, and let's kick it off right about now. So the Pontiac Silverdome opened in 1975. It sits on 199 acres of land, and when it was first built, it had a fiberglass fabric roof held up by air pressure, which was something very unique at the time. It was an architectural first. First time they had done that in a major athletic facility. The seating capacity was 82,666 plus. It was the largest stadium for the NFL until FedEx Field in Washington, D.C. expanded the capability to over 85,000 in the year 2000. It was the home of the Detroit Lions from 1975 to 2001. And the Detroit Pistons from 1978 to 1988. It was also the home of the Cherry Bowl and the Motor City Bowl. And in 2012, the Silverdome served as the home venue for the Detroit Mechanics of the American Ultimate Disc League, obviously the most important league around. It was the host of the 1979 NBA All-Star Game, Super Bowl XVI, and, of course, WrestleMania III, where the WWE claimed they set an indoor attendance record of 93,173 people. Although some people will dispute that the number was slightly fictionalized, as WWE tends to exaggerate, and the capacity of the stadium did not. There was no way they could have fit 93,000 people in there, but WWE includes ushers, people working, anyone in the parking lot, and possibly anyone driving by. Realistically, most people estimate that the WWE did put about 85,000 people in the Pontiac Silverdome. So why is it called the Silverdome? That's a great question everybody asks, because when you look at it from the side, it does appear to have a white fiberglass roof. Well, it was named that because the aerial view showed a reflection of the sky, and between the white and the blue, it had a slightly silver look. And that name just caught on, and forever it's been called the Pontiac Silverdome. I personally went there as a child many a times, and it was home of NBA basketball games for the Detroit Pistons, where they literally put a tarp separating the huge venue to where everybody sat on one side of the tarp because it was just way too large to watch basketball. In the 1980s, part of the dome did collapse. There was damage to the roof from a heavy snowfall, and the Pistons decided to temporarily move to the Joe Louis Arena, and eventually moved permanently to the Palace of Auburn Hills, just 4 miles away. In 2009, the Silverdome was put up for auction with no reserve, and it sold for about $550,000. That's less than 1% of what it cost to build. Think about that. 200 acres, one of the largest dome stadiums in the world for the price of a very nice house in suburban Detroit. I personally would have moved in, set up shop, and made the world's largest indoor basketball court. Eventually, the stadium became a complete wreck. It was used for practically nothing near the end. Around 2014, the owners sold off the stadium's contents, and if you go on eBay today, you can still pick up things like seats for a very reasonable price. Around 2014, it was also used, the parking area was also used to store cars from a major Volkswagen recall. So it was nothing more than a huge parking lot for decaying old Volkswagens that didn't meet their emissions tests. In 2017, the owners decided to tear it down. The upper ring of the stadium was imploded. The first attempt was on December 3rd, 2017, which failed. They tried again, it's a tough stadium. December 4th, 2017, it finally did implode, and they tore the thing down. In September 2019, it was announced that Amazon would develop the site, which they have since done, and it is now a major Amazon distribution center for the Detroit area and the suburbs. The stadium cost $55 million to build, seated 80,000 people, plus had 102 luxury suites and 7,300 club seats. I personally think this was a beautiful and wonderful stadium, certainly one of the world's greatest stadiums in its heyday, and it's absolutely fantastic. I do like kind of giving a little piece of history and making sure that the legend of this stadium lasts. If you have any videos that you would like to see, leave us a comment below. Thank you so much for your support here at World's Greatest. We now have 130,000 subscribers, almost 140,000, and hopefully we'll keep growing because of you. Stick around where I teach you, or excuse me, stick around for our sponsors, Thinergy.
I just want to give a big shout out to everyone who is losing weight with Thinergy. Keep up the great work, guys. You are all doing so awesome. Now, ways that I continue to stay healthy and be in shape is by always giving myself a minimum of 30 minutes each day to stay active. Whether it's just going up the stairs instead of using an elevator, whether it's going to the gym or doing something fun like ice skating, which I love to do, I always try to stay active. And I know sometimes it can be hard to keep yourself motivated to do that, but the ways that I keep motivated is by thinking to myself that if I am physically healthy, it also improves my mental health majorly. And also fun ways that I stay motivated is by doing different types of exercises, whether it's taking a Zumba class or a spin class. Also joining your family and friends with you is a great way to keep yourself encouraged to stay healthy. So have fun, everyone, and good luck!